Darrell, also, I think you asked about the SPLOST referendum, which comes up both of part, we're in the process of developing our project list, and I believe 42 million, 40 of the 64 million that we're estimated to receive is aimed towards utilities.
And the current SPLOST we're in out of the 68 million, 54 million.
So those two SPLOST referendums really had allowed us to put about $100 million into these utility projects.
What is that do?
It comes up in November. We're in the process of, you know, the county and the cities in the county are putting their project list together. We've already got ours pretty much finalized. And then we have to promote that and get the citizens to vote for it.
Our list is easy. We start with Darrell.
I was about to say,
everybody else is a little soft, but we start with Darrell.
Good on your calendar for making that a priority. I mean, I think that's so.
It's a priority with us because that's the way we try not to raise property taxes. We raise revenue through cost taxes. And that's been our method of operation over the years, and we kept our property taxes low, and the people that travel down the interstate, some of you come up here and eat and shop in my town and help us raise that money. Of course, you probably appreciate it.
I mean, I understand the vision of the infrastructure, you call it infrastructure tax?
It's not, it's a SPLOST tax, but it has to be spent on capital projects.
Yes, we are, and I guess my question is, on the last ballot here in Columbia County, we had, by being a charter county, we was asking citizens to approve an infrastructure tax, which was strictly with the infrastructure. And with the vision to reduce alcohol taxes even more, and it got beat down 2-1. So my question to you all are, what is the backup plan if this does not pass?
Just bring it up again. The history behind our SPLOST tax is we've only had one occasion when that tax was defeated, and that was during a presidential race when most people were interested in voting for one of the presidential candidates and no on everything else. We came back the next year and it was approved. Yeah. And so this is not a a general election and everything. We do have city councilmen and mayor's races, so there will be, you know, the city and most of the city residents are pretty much in favor of this way of doing business.
So the people do not hold active support tax during
general election. Historically, that's true everywhere.
All right, I think that's
any questions? Is there any more?